Hello, good morning students. In the last video lecture, we discussed price discrimination. What is price discrimination? Charging different prices from different customers or different groups of customers for similar goods and services, that is called price discrimination. We also discussed what are the types or forms of price discrimination, personal discrimination, age discrimination, location discrimination, etc. etc. Today we are going to discuss the most important question of this syllabus, most important question of this chapter, essential condition for price discrimination. Generally question kaise pucha jayega, what is price discrimination, in which circumstances it is possible and profitable. Okay, so hum log discuss karenge aaj कि इन विच सिचुएशन इन विच सर्कमस्टेंसेस प्राइस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इज पॉसिबल एंड प्रॉफिटेबल. फर्स्ट एंड एसेंशियल कंडीशन इज मोनोपोली. ऑफ कोर्स प्राइस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन परफेक्ट कंपटीशन, बिकॉज इन परफेक्ट कंपटीशन देर आर लार्ज नंबर्स ऑफ सेलर्स इन द मार्केट एंड इंडिविजुअल फर्म ऑक्यूपाइज अ वेरी स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ टोटल मार्केट. सो ही कैन नॉट इन्फ्लुएंस मार्केट प्राइस. उसको जो भी मार्केट प्राइस है वो एक्सेप्ट करना पड़ेगा. And buyers and sellers have perfect knowledge of market. So if he try to make price discrimination, he has to lose all the customers. So the first and the most important condition is monopoly. There should be monopoly situation, near monopoly situation. However, price discrimination can also be practiced in imperfect competition like monopolistic competition and particularly oligopoly. Okay. But price discrimination is not possible in perfect competition. Second, segmentation of the market. The monopolist can indulge in price discrimination successfully only in the condition where he has at least two or more market. Agar market ek hi hai to total demand ko divide nahi kar sakta. So at least he has two or more market. For example, railway can make price discrimination by the segmenting of markets like first class, AC chair car, then second class, two tier AC, three tier AC, etc. etc. Cinema house can make price discrimination by balcony and upper class. In recent time, मल्टीप्लेक्स में रॉयल क्लास और मार्बल क्लास और एग्जीक्यूटिव क्लास एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. मगर वो कब पॉसिबल है? व्हेन द मोनोपोलिस्ट हैज एटलीस्ट टू और मोर मार्केट. ओके, सो देयर शुड बी सेगमेंटेशन. सेगमेंट वो डिफरेंटली सेगमेंट होना चाहिए. ओके, एंड सो दैट इज पॉसिबल ओनली इन एटलीस्ट टू और मार्केट. ओके, से थर्ड दैट elasticity of demand differ in each market. This is also the very very important condition, that elasticity of demand should be different in different market. Agar elasticity same hai to price discrimination possible nahi hai. Can you make a point? Elasticity for one market, elasticity of demand should be perfectly inelastic. And for one market, it should be more elastic. Then only price discrimination is possible. For example, airlines make price discrimination business class and economic class. क्यों कर सकते हैं? Because business class में travel करने वाले लोग कितने होंगे? Only few. Okay? They are upper strata of the society, upper segment of the society. और उनकी प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी कितनी है? ऑलमोस्ट इनलास्टिक. व्हाट एवर चेंज इन प्राइस, देयर इज नो चेंज इन व्हाट एवर चेंज इन प्राइस, देयर इज नो चेंज इन डिमांड. बट फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मिडिल क्लास एंड अपर मिडिल क्लास, दे आर जनरली ट्रैवलिंग बाय इकोनॉमिक क्लास. सो ऑब्वियसली देयर इलास्टिसिटी इज ग्रेटर देन वन. प्रोपोर्शनेट चेंज इन डिमांड is greater than proportional change in price. तो वो एयरलाइन की बुकिंग तब करवाएंगे जब उसको डिस्काउंट ज्यादा मिल रहा होगा. आगे से एयरलाइन का बुकिंग करवाएंगे जिससे उसको वो प्राइस कम प्राइस में टिकट मिल जाए, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. ओके, देयर इलास्टिसिटी इज greater than one. For example, and so far as railway में भी ऐसा ही है. Person who is traveling by second class, उसकी elasticity of demand अलग होगी. Person who is traveling by first AC or two tier AC, उसका elasticity different होगा. Okay, getting my point? So the monopolist can indulge in price discrimination only when elasticity is different in different market. Okay? If elasticity is same, price discrimination is not possible. Cost of keeping the market separate must not be too high. Here it is the situation where price discrimination is possible, but it is not profitable. Okay? मान लीजिए कि एक सिनेमा हाउस है. सिनेमा हाउस हैज इनकर ह्यूज कॉस्ट बाय फॉर मेकिंग द टू मार्केट और टू थ्री मार्केट सेपरेट्स फॉर रॉयल क्लास एंड मार्बल क्लास एंड एग्जीक्यूटिव क्लास. आपको अपने हमने देख लिया कि सिनेमा ओनर हैज स्पेंट 10 लाख रुपीस फॉर मेकिंग द मार्केट सेपरेट, बट He is not getting advantages. उसको market separate करने से कोई फायदा नहीं हो रहा है और उसको हो रहा है only 5 lakh rupees. He is getting advantage or getting profit of only 5 lakh rupees by separating the markets, different market. तो उस situation में हम लोग क्या बोलेंगे कि price discrimination is possible here, but price discrimination is not profitable. Okay? So price discrimination should be possible as well as it should be profitable. Next, non-transferability characteristics of goods and services. Obviously, the monopolist can indulge in price discrimination only in the situation when the service, nature of service or characteristics of goods and services should be non-transferable. हम लोगों ने देखा कि इन पर्सनल डिस्क्रिमिनेशन दैट डॉक्टर जनरली चार्ज हाई ऑपरेशन फीस फ्रॉम रिच पेशेंट एंड लोअर ऑपरेशन फीस फ्रॉम पुअर पेशेंट. वो डॉक्टर अगर करना चाहे तो वो कर सकते हैं. लॉयर कैन ऑल्सो मेक प्राइस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बाई चार्जिंग डिफरेंट प्राइसेस फ्रॉम डिफरेंट क्लाइंट्स. ओके, यो क्यों कर सकते हैं? बिकॉज द सर्विस इज नॉन ट्रांसफरेबल. The rich person cannot get service on behalf of poor person. अगर rich person को कोई operation करवाना है उसके appendix का, तो उसकी जगह वो कोई poor person का नहीं करवा सकता. Getting my point? So it is non-transferable service. And also, then only price discrimination is possible. हम लोगों ने वो भी discuss किया था कि hairdresser, barber generally charge lower rates for children's haircut and higher rates for adults' haircuts. Okay? So, agar mere baal badh jaye, to main chote bachche ka baal nahi katwa sakta. Getting my point? The service is non-transferable. That is why the price discrimination is possible. Okay? So, personal service like doctor, the engineer, okay, carpenter, the service is not transferable. No possibility of reset. Price discrimination can be possible only in the situation when there is no possibility of reset of the same product from higher market to lower market. Sorry, from lower price market to higher price market. We discussed in the earlier lecture that Gujarat Electric Board, more precisely abhi kahenge to Dakshin Gujarat Vij Company Limited, it generally charged different rates for different uses. Agriculture ke use ke liye wo minimum charge karenge, maan lijiye ke 2 rupees per unit, for industry 4 rupees per unit, for domestic 5 rupees per unit, and for commercial 8 rupees per unit. Okay, this is generally this is the charges imposed charges by DDVCL, agricultural use, industrial use, domestic use, and commercial purpose. ओके, वो पॉसिबल कम है. क्यों है? बिकॉज द एग्रीकल्चर के यूज में अगर कोई फार्मर है, एक्स फार्मर है, वो चीप इलेक्ट्रिसिटी परचेस करता है डीजीवीसीएल से, और वो डोमेस्टिक पर्पस के लिए रीसेल अगर कर सके तो इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. So if farmers cannot directly sell cheap electricity for domestic use or for the commercial use, okay, this is legally it is not allowed. Okay, it is punishable offense. That is the reason why price discrimination is possible. Okay, because there is no possibility of the resale of the goods, same goods or services from lower price market to higher price. Next, ignorance and laziness of the buyers. This is also very very important factor, that many times the buyers are not aware that the same product or similar products are available at the lower price in other market. And sometimes even though they are aware, they, because of their laziness, they don't want to go to a lower price market. Second, let go attitude. When prices, the price difference is very small and negligible, they avoid to go to lower price. Agar price mein bahut hi mamooli farak hai to let go, hota chalta hai, we should purchase from here only, why should we go there to purchase certain things. Wo let go attitude hota hai, iske wajah se hi price differentiation, price discrimination is possible. Consumers' illusion. This is also a psychological factor. Consumers' illusion. Higher price means better quality. If I pay higher price, I will get derive greater pleasure. Sometimes, वो हर समय वो सही नहीं होता है. Sometimes it is true that as you are paying higher price of the product, obviously you will get better quality. But every time वो सही नहीं है. I'm giving example, particularly in services. Suppose there is एक बड़ा हॉल है, उसमें गजल का प्रोग्राम है, और ये गजल के प्रोग्राम में एक हॉल में मान लीजिए कि 20 रो है. सपोज कि x पर्सन बैठा है सेकंड, x पर्सन इज सिटिंग ऑन द सेकंड रो एंड y पर्सन इज सिटिंग ऑन द 17th रो. नाउ x, एज x पर्सन इज सिटिंग ऑन द 7th रो, सेकेंड रो, ऑब्वियसली ही हैज पेड हायर प्राइस, उसने ज्यादा वैल्यूड की टिकट ली है. ओके, उसका जो टिकट का प्राइस है वो 5000 है, वाई पर्सन का टिकट का प्राइस है वो ओनली 1000 रुपीज का है. देयर इज हार्डली एनी डिफरेंस ऑफ लिसनिंग गजल फ्रॉम द सेकेंड रो एंड द 17th रो. देयर इज नो डिफरेंस, नो सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस. But as X person has paid higher price to get higher price to get ticket, she will derive more pleasure. कि मैं तो first row में बैठा हूँ, second row में बैठा हूँ. Okay, so this is an illusion. Due to consumer illusion, price discrimination is possible. Okay. Next, separated by distance or tariff barriers. We discussed in the last video lecture that dumping is an example of location discrimination or geographical discrimination. China, I have given example of China. That China is selling its product at lower at higher price in the domestic market and lower price in the international market. Okay, China wo kar sakta hai. What is the reason? Because two markets are separated by distance and tariff barrier. Suppose ki China X commodity apne country mein $10 mein sell karta hai, and same product it is selling in India at $6. International transaction, so international currency we have used. Okay. Now agar koi India ka businessman aisa soche कि मैं $6 में इंडिया में परचेस करूं और वही चीज चाइना में फिर से $8 to $9 में सेल करूं, तो वो पॉसिबल होगा? नहीं पॉसिबल होगा. व्हाई? बिकॉज देयर इज अ डिस्टेंस. वो कितना किलोमीटर्स का डिस्टेंस होगा, उसको ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कॉस्ट लगेगा. एंड व्हेन दे चाइना से इंपोर्ट करने में इंपोर्ट ड्यूटी लगेगी, चाइना अगेन एक्सपोर्ट करने में एक्सपोर्ट ड्यूटी बननी पड़ेगी उसको. ओके, सो टू मार्केट्स आर सेपरेटेड बाय डिस्टेंस एंड टैरिफ बैरियर, दैट इज व्हाई प्राइस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इज पॉसिबल. last legal section. Okay, the Gujarat Electric Board can legal. It is legally allowed that it can make price discrimination. It charge lowest rate for agriculture use and highest rate for commercial use. Different segment उसने बना रखे हैं, agricultural use, industrial use, domestic use and commercial use. Okay, it is legally allowed, legally sanctioned. Okay, then price discrimination is possible. Railway can also make price discrimination legally disallowed. Okay, so these are the conditions. Okay, I would like to repeat that price discrimination means charging different prices from different customers or different groups of customers for similar kind of goods and services. Sorry. So price discrimination, in this video lecture we discuss when price discrimination is possible and profitable. What are the essential conditions for the price discrimination? Monopoly, different market segment, different elasticity, non-transferability, the characteristics of goods and services, no possibility of resale, consumer illusions, etc. Okay, aaj ke liye itna rahega. Thank you.